interaction with all the stakeholders there. Now their delegation comprising all the dignitaries arrived here to PMC, and together we are trying to learn with each other's experiences and ideas, and we want to create a platform for enabling joint learning, experience sharing and piloting of specific initiatives. So next, what did we learn from our Birmingham visit? Like Birmingham has different environment, social and economic and political, and we do have different environment.
Basically we want to bring the health and nutrition on the debate of public.
There should be discussions around the topic, otherwise we can't take it forward. So in Birmingham there is takeaway culture, like people very few people cook their food at their homes, unlike Pune. So they are facing different kind of challenges. So we want to stimulate and create conducive policy environment for healthy and safe eating out options. Like people are not cooking at their home, so how better we can make takeaway options? They should not be unhealthy, and there should be hygiene and healthy options. With that, can we support the local economy? Like all of you must be aware about the self-help groups models working throughout India. Everywhere we are finding self-help groups of women or men. So we had discussion with our counterparts there. Can there be self-help groups of some people? They can provide economic, cheap hygiene and healthy options to all these takeaways. So we discussed our models of self-help groups with those people. Second one is when I did my presentation there in Birmingham City Council, we displayed lot of initiatives taken by Pune Municipal Corporation and state government and central government. Our all the health initiatives and interventions are based on the huge amount of databases we are available with us regarding public health. But unlike this, Birmingham City Council was not having that much databases with them. So if we are having health profile of our population, then it would be great to drive and take few health initiatives. Third one is this is regarding Birmingham City Council. They want to support home cooking skills. Like we visited one food school at Harbin there, and there they teach how to prepare healthy and good nutritious food. So we need to revive that culture of home cooking skills. One thing we found there in Birmingham, and we have started facing that here in Pune also. Like when both the partners, father and mother, both are working, so they have somewhere that feel that guilty feeling somewhere in their mind that they are not able to give proper attention and proper time to their children. So they tend to pamper their children. Whatever children demand, they tend to provide all those things. And this very vacuum or vulnerability is captured by all the multinational companies who are targeting through their advertisings to the children only. So can we control the junk food marketing aimed at children? That is what we are thinking. So these multinational companies are very huge. We can't control really. So if we can't control the supply side, can we control the demand side? Can we bring this health and nutrition agenda on our public discussions? And can we create some pressure groups? They will force these multinational companies to provide healthy options in their takeaways or in their food chains. So can we do that? And fifth one is, in Birmingham we found that they are having lowest breastfeeding rates. And so this gives huge space for winning food industry. So can we, through the awareness, can we amend that? That is what we want to think. Next. Here I have given few data regarding Pune, about its area and its population and its our other strengths. Next one. Pune, as you all of know, we call it cultural capital of Maharashtra, and it is second largest corporation, municipal corporation after Mumbai. So we are having population more than 4 million, and it has very strong IT industry base and manufacturing base across, auto and engineering industries are placed there. We are having strong human capital base here. Like, we are having more than 800 colleges based in Pune, so it attracts students not only from India but all over the world. As I said, this is cultural capital of Maharashtra. Next one. If we go through the vital health statistics of Pune, like infant mortality rate or maternal mortality rate or birth rate or death rate, so you can find that IMR and MMR are little higher side. It is lower than national average, but it is higher than Maharashtra state average, because as I have said, Pune has great health facilities. So it attracts patients around the district. So that is the reason why these rates are higher we find in Pune. Next. If we analyze the Pune situation, we find that children under 5 years who are wasted and severely wasted, their average is higher than national average. We find overnutrition in Pune city. So somewhere we find that malnutrition is there, and overnutrition of women and men is also there. Women are obese and overweight, and they are with high blood sugar. So here we find the need for proper diet initiatives and awareness among the population. They are not necessarily malnourished, but sometimes they are overnourished also, and this needs to be corrected. Next one. So on this background, I will not go into very deep in the health statistic, but on this background, Pune Municipal Corporation and state government and central government have taken several health initiatives, like midday meal program. In Birmingham City Council also, they are also having midday meal program, and here we run it with the help of women self-help groups. And this midday meal program has ensured that school dropout rates will be reduced. It has ensured a higher number of attendance of children in the schools. So apart from nutrition, it has ensured presence of students or children in the schools also. Second one is ICDS scheme, Integrated Child Development Services. So here we target children of 0 to 6 year age group, and pregnant and lactating mothers, and adolescent girls also. So, very crucial period of this early childhood or pregnant and lactating mothers, we are providing or doing health interventions at this age. Second one is Sassoon General Hospital. Here we, through CSR, we provide food for patients and their relatives during their stay in the hospital. Next one is deworming drive. So you can find that there are very small drives targeted at very small interventions, like deworming or vitamin A or iron folic acid deficiencies. We could take these initiatives merely because we had the updated data of health profile of our population. That's why we came to know that what is lacking there. So in this deworming drive, then next one is prevention of vitamin A deficiency drive, then iron and folic acid supplements, so antenatal care, postnatal care. So all these are very small initiatives based on our data we could take. Then next one is diarrhea control program. So we can find that hand wash, we can find that diarrheal infections can be reduced by 40% and respiratory infections by 30% just with the small intervention of hand wash. So we are trying to aware our children through all these initiatives and their parents and teachers also, so that these initiatives will be sustainable initiatives. Next.